everyone to know that there is a serious growth in Cantanedo's growth. The recommendations that have been made by this committee, the life of this committee was 5 days. The life of this committee, the select committee, ends today. So that is why we were able to make recommendations that will be used to sanitize the entire county of Kasa. We are not punishing anyone. We appreciate the role that the Department of Health has been doing, especially during this pandemic in the speakers. We know that they've been banning the media going to help when they can. But for this case of Peter Kiblanga Kige, we want justice yesterday, we want justice today, we want justice tomorrow. And Mr. Speaker, sir, I pray that we vote so that we hear everybody's vote. Want to see those who will stand for justice? Want to see all those who will stand for Peter again? And all those who will not stand for Peter again. When this will be written, I want to be the light books on it. Look at this interesting footage, Mr. Speaker, sir. It shows exactly what happened. It shows exactly how Peter Kigen was taken to casualty, from casualty to mortuary, and from mortuary back to casualty. What else do we want? The County Government Act is very clear. It stipulates the functions of the county assembly. We are a legislative arm of the county government, speakers. When we make recommendations, our recommendations are binding. Whenever a witness is invited to appear before the committee, the speaker, sir, at the invitation, we are the level of the High Court, the speaker, sir. Whenever an invitee, and especially an employee of the county, declines, dishonors, refuses to honor an invitation, the speaker, sir, that is disrespecting the assembly, that is disrespecting the house. And the standing orders are very, very clear. So, Mr. Speaker, sir, look at how Kiblanga's case went as far as Holland, it went to Germany, it is all over the world. So, the recommendations and the actions of this House today, Mr. Speaker, sir, will go as far as where I don't even want to say, Mr. Speaker, sir. And history will judge this house. We are a house of rules and procedures. The recommendations and the resolutions that we will pass today will be binding, Mr. Speaker. Sir. Mr. Speaker, sir, the CEC for Health, one Dr. Shadra Mutai, we appreciate and respect him. When he appeared before the committee, Mr. Speaker, sir, he was very disrespectful. You can never disrespect the committee by telling the committee, I am neither God nor Satan. Mr. Speaker, sir, that is unparliamentary, that is disrespectful, and Mr. Speaker, sir, number two, lied to the committee that there was a meeting between unions. We asked him, which unions, Mr. Speaker, sir? He was unable to comprehend and say the number of unions that were having a meeting. At one time, he talked about Kudea. When we asked him, the Morticians, which union does the Morticians belong? He was unable to tell us. So, Mr. Speaker, sir, failure to appear before any committee of the assembly, Mr. Speaker, sir, must be punished, Mr. Speaker, sir. Number two, Mr. Speaker, sir, the MOH, the superintendent, Dr. Jeruya, Mr. Speaker, sir, he is unable to discharge the functions of our medical superintendent, Mr. Speaker, sir. So I propose that what the committee recommended, Mr. Speaker, sir, it should be adopted as is, Mr. Speaker, sir. Number three, Mr. Speaker, sir, the clinician who was on duty, if it was your brother, if it was your son, if it was your husband, would you be still wearing the same shoe that you want to oppose this report and go around, take us around and say, oh, We want justice for Peter Kigen, and at the same time we want justice for the doctors or the medics. We want justice for Peter Kigen. It is either justice or nothing. So Mr. Speaker, sir, the morticians, we also recommended that they be retrained. Mr. Speaker, sir, We appreciate them. We know the kind of work that they do, but they must be responsible. This assembly, Mr. Speaker, sir, appropriates the highest, the lion's share of every financial year's budget to the Department of Health, Mr. Speaker. Are we getting services commensurate to the vote, to the kind of funds that this assembly appropriates for the Department of Health, Mr. Speaker? The Department of Health must rise. They must rise to the occasion. They must rise. And Mr. Speaker, sir, finally, I want justice for Peter Gigan today. Justice, 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 Mr. Speaker, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, for the chance you've given me so that I can say something about this report. First, Mr. Speaker, I want to thank God because we are informed that today Peter Kigen is alive. And at the same time, Mr. Speaker, we also want to thank our healthcare workers because of the work they are doing. Right now, Mr. Speaker, we know there are very many people who are hospitalized, Mr. Speaker. And we know, Mr. Speaker, that they have done thousands of successful operations. They have taken care of a lot of patients, Mr. Speaker, and we appreciate them. Mr. Speaker, in as much as you want justice for Peter Kigen, Mr. Speaker, and that is what we want, Mr. Speaker. But I like what Mheshimiwa Albert, that is the chair held, and Mheshimiwa Majority Leader, when he said that, talking about chair budget, I said chair budget, when he talked about the budget that the health department take, he said that the health department is given 1.9 billion. And out of the 1.9 billion, 1.6 billion goes to the current expenditure. And 500 million goes to the government board. It is, Mr. Speaker, the same department in our own country, Mr. Speaker, collects more than 50% of county revenue, Mr. Speaker. And yes, even if we collect from them, Mr. Speaker, it is the money that goes to our CRF, Mr. Speaker. I also like what Mheshimiwa Deputy Chief said, that history will charge us. Indeed, history will charge us, Mr. Speaker, as a house of rules and procedures and house that is guided by laws, Mr. Speaker. If we fail, Mr. Speaker, to be guided by laws, then history will charge us. Mr. Speaker, before I say something, Mr. Speaker, I want again to emphasize on what is on page 6, Mr. Speaker. That is about the jurisprudence of a high court in Kenya, Mr. Speaker, and that is recently. It was on 1st March 2011, overruling that the name of a patient had died, Mr. Speaker. We thank God that the chances we are looking for the Peter Kiplangan will be there. And the Tabor God is there to see justice done for him, Mr. Speaker. I want to emphasize that the court is not oblivious. Again, oblivious means, Mr. Speaker, not aware or concerned about what is happening around because of lack of some specific knowledge, Mr. Speaker. It's not oblivious of public policy requirements that professionals in the medical field ought to act diligently, Mr. Speaker, and professionally in discharge of their duties. As a result, Mr. Speaker, of the applicant's misconduct as established by the Pharmacy and Poisons Board, that is a body that is mandated, Mr. Speaker, to take care of health care professionals, Mr. Speaker. An innocent life was lost. The law demands that the applicant be disciplined accordingly. But in so doing, the appropriate discipline has to be meted out by the relevant body and in accordance with the law, Mr. Speaker, so that it will not charge us, Mr. Speaker. We should not leave the extent of punishment that our professionals should be given, Mr. Speaker. I'm continuing. This court of, that is the court that ruled, that is the charge. That the Pharmacy and Poisons Board, yes, Mr. Speaker. I'm finishing, Mr. Speaker. Then we move on to the station, Mr. Speaker. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Mr. Speaker. So, let me move an amendment because of the same, Mr. Speaker. I do not, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Just right on the point of order, Mr. Speaker. One honorable Dennis Kirui, Mr. Speaker, is part of this recommendation since he was a member, Mr. Speaker. But he changes overnight, Mr. Speaker. And let's tell us what changed overnight, Mr. Speaker, because he is a member of this Select Committee, Mr. Speaker, and he's part of this recommendation, Mr. Speaker. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm part of the committee, but I heard that the second voice, Mr. Speaker, and it is captured by that, Mr. Speaker. I am, and Mr. Speaker, the honorable member should not say that there's something that changed, Mr. Speaker, overnight. You should change because I heard the second voice, Mr. Speaker. I heard and it was captured by answer, Mr. Speaker. And this is what I say.
Mr. Speaker, sir, is it in order for the honorable member to lie to the House? The report is very clear. The report has his name as one of the committee members. Nowhere in the report is captured as a happy standing voice, Mr. Speaker. So it is either his dissenting voice should have been captured. And again, Mr. Speaker, sir, he knows to support the motion. He writes to make or the Speaker amendment, Mr. Speaker, sir. So the membership is really being called. Is that in order, Mr. Speaker?
The Honorable Dennis Kirui, you have seen from the report that you are a member of this committee, and I have not seen from the 16 pages, 16 pages of this report.
Maybe that was an oversight, Mr. Speaker, but it is captured by answer, Mr. Speaker. It is captured by answer, Mr. Speaker. But it was captured in the answer to the speaker.
What we are dealing with is the report. The Honorable Evan Tibet.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir, for giving me this opportunity so that I would also give my submission on this matter. I would like also to thank the honorable members of this committee for the work they did. Because all of us were seeking justice for one Kigen, Kiplangat Kigen. And there are some issues that I see some of the honorable members are having some concerns. And all of us in the assembly, we don't want to lose this report. We don't want to entirely lose this report. Because for a fact, we are seeking justice one Kiplangat Kigen. So, with your ruling, Mr. Speaker, I would want you to guide this House whether we can add more recommendations, do some amendments. Because also I have a recommendation which I was expecting to see, but maybe the committee they did it already and they were so busy. One of the recommendations is the waiver. Yeah? No, it's not that. It's not that. I'm talking about the waiver, the fees. No, but this is not a vision. What I have here is a vision. And I don't see the recommendation why you say one could like that again, he should not pay even a penny. No, he said, but it is not official here. No, that is a rumor. And that is his opinion. I'm just giving that maybe Mr. Speaker, sir, you'd allow more recommendations, even an amendment, so that at least we form a watertight report. I'm in agreement with everything here. But you see, this House is full of people with a lot of ideas. We can allow more members, because even there are some issues that were raised here, which are very important. Even in this period of pandemic, we have issues at the hospitals, our health facilities, in terms of lack of PPEs, equipment, and all that kind of stuff. Maybe we should add more. We should allow members to add more, because we cannot say this committee is has got monopoly of knowledge. All of us in the assembly, we would want to add more recommendations so that we seek justice for what Kiplangat again. That is all I'm saying. So allow members, Mr. Speaker, with your ruling and your guidance, we want to build this thing to be very important. It will capture a lot of things. There are reported cases in our health facilities that we want to capture with this report. So give guidance, Mr. Speaker, sir. Thank you.
Can we have somebody moving a residential hotel so that we can sit beyond the site? Or if there is none, we'll just go on and then go to the site. Oh, can I put a question?
Yes.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker, sir, for giving me this opportunity, Mr. Speaker. Under your ruling, Mr. Speaker, that I reply, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it is very important to note that the time which was allocated to this committee was limited, Mr. Speaker. And we were concentrating, even on the report, on the issue of cartels, Mr. Speaker. That is why all our efforts were concentrated on the incident which happened in Kakatek, Mr. Speaker. And Mr. Speaker, maybe the committee of health should rise from the from now onwards. And now, because they have realized there is a mess in the entire facilities, Mr. Speaker, to raise and go around and come up with more recommendations, Mr. Speaker. Because of the time, Mr. Speaker, I want to thank the honorable members and to thank the members of the select committee, Mr. Speaker, for supporting this noble report, Mr. Speaker. This report, we wanted justice to be served, Mr. Speaker. The whole world is looking at us, Mr. Speaker, and we want, Mr. Speaker, to be sincere to ourselves, Mr. Speaker. We don't want predetermined, Mr. Speaker, because of time, Mr. Speaker, allow me, Mr. Speaker, to thank the honorable members for supporting this motion and keeping justice to Kiplangat again. Thank you and God bless.
You see, all of us belong to this house. All of us belong to this house, and we will all check our votes. So I have to propose this one. The ones who support the election, decide the ones who oppose.
Do it! Do it! Thank you. Can we be quiet?
Yes.
This is not life and death. Though what we are discussing is very important. We should not shout, and we should not look like we are disordering people. I think what we said is that we wanted a vote. And I heard that you also wanted justice for the doctors, and you wanted justice for the family. So, because that is the position, and that is what you want, I will request the Honorable Philip Ron, how do you vote?
Yes.
The second person is Dennis. How do you vote?
Give the habit.
Justice to begin, and
I leave justice to the medic. We are in a confused world where the pandemic is terrorizing nurses and doctors. And we are now in a people who don't touch me.
Because you are not allowed to make any amendments as we have requested. I thought no. The Honorable Mbonjabu.
On behalf of Jerlani at work, where my patient is coming from, I am a committee member, I am a select committee member, I vote yes. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the good people of Kapaten and where the facility of Kapaten Hospital is based, I want to know. That is your point.
Daniel Nefich.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. On behalf of the people of Kapaten, I want to know. Justice for all.
Thank you. Eric, for it.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir. On behalf of Kapiaka Chisamundua, I vote yes.
Thank you.
Here.
Aaron Rashid. Dutton. Kapiagon Poet. Absent. Humphrey Kirui. On behalf of the people of Kapsusel, I vote no. And that is for all.
David, Michel, Hudson, Joseph Kirui, Albert Kirui.
On behalf of the people of Korea, and that is for the again, I thought yes. And at least we have seen what money can do. Thank you.
Thank you. Joseph Kirui.
On behalf of Soin Ward, I vote yes, and also let us make justice for innocent souls that is again.
Will you check that?
I vote no for justice for all, Medik and Kigen Kiplangat. Thank you.
Thank you. going to say no.
Thank you.
The name, the Honorable Philip Bruno, is still in session. The Honorable Hillary Gates. The names are 22. The eyes are 15. So the names are it. Let's go.